Boom. What it is, what it do, people. Thank you for coming back for another motherfucking video. As you can see, we out here in the wilderness. Got you guys set up in a nice little stand and shit, you know. We out here in a dirty ass Des Plaines River. Why did I choose to go up here? Because I thought it was going to be scenic. But really, it's musty as fuck. But whatever. We out here going to do this review for you guys. Got my motherfucking Revolution hat, you know what I'm saying? So you know shit's serious. Boom. Tales and Travels, people. So if you guys don't know what Tales and Travels is, it's a sister brand from Revolution. You know how Cresco has High Supply, Rhythm has Good Green, and Shine. It's like, it's basically like kind of like their bulk product. But really, what goes into Tales and Travels, someone had commented like, hey man, what determines what strain goes to Revolution and what strains go into Tales and Travels? And they responded saying, really, the easy shit for them to grow goes to Tales and Travels. The more craft, more hands-on shit that takes a little bit harder to grow goes into Revolution's jars. So that's kind of like the difference on how they pick which one goes into what bag. But yeah, this is the Tales and Travels brought to you by Revolution. Tales and Travels is more of a budget-saving brand, I want to say. About like 45 for the 8th compared to like 60 for the premium Revolution jars in the Mylar bags. But I really, really like these Mylar bags. They're really dope. Has all the little, you know, art on there. And then on the back, it has all the info you could ever want. From the strain lineage to how you're going to feel, top terpenes, all the percentage for the... We're right by a fucking airport, Paul Walker Airport, so all these fucking planes in and out. But yeah, gives you, for all the THC chasers, even gives you all that info on there, you know what I'm saying? All that shit, which I'm sure it's supposed to anyways. But yeah, this is that... Strawberry Shortcake, or Raspberry Shortcake, so sorry. The Raspberry Shortcake from Tales and Travels. It is the Raspberry Bellinelli crossed with the Slaps. Now, those two strains, let me break them down to you real quick. The Raspberry Bellinelli is an original staple from Revolution. I believe it is the Cherry Do-Si-Do crossed with the Lemon Tree. Already those have, like, I never got the chance to try it. That's from back in the day, you know what I'm saying? But already, that shit sounds fucking gas. That sounds really, really good. That lemon cherry Do-Si-Do, like, come on, now stop playing. And then the Slaps. The Slaps is a Runts crossed with the Grease Monkey. So the Runts already, if you don't know what Runts are, man, like, where you been in the past couple of years, Runts has been a very hyped up strain, you know what I'm saying? Some companies out here have Runts, their own version of it, but it ain't really it, you know what I'm saying? With the very hyped up name like Runts, if your ass does not grow that shit right, that shit is not gonna be smoking right. And it's a very, very big disappointment because it's such a hyped up strain that it has to live up to that potential, you know what I'm saying? And then that cross with Grease Monkey, that's what gives you Slaps. Now, Slaps and Raspberry Bellinelli put together is what gives you this motherfucking Raspberry Shortcake. Now, I fell in love with this bitch as soon as I smelt her. I was like, oh my goodness. The smell from the lemon tree, that zesty, sour, lemon, sweet candy smell is fucking phenomenal, dude. Straight up like a lemon head with a little gassy, creamy sweetness. It's so fucking good. I fell in love. Ended up buying a half ounce, the party pack. Came back, bought another half ounce. They ran out of half ounces, I got a quarter. Ran out of the quarter, I got the fucking last eighth. Now, until them bitches hit the shelves again, you know what I'm saying? This is kind of the last one I've seen out here. Went out to Rise and Niles to cop this motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? Shout out. But yeah, let's go ahead and bring you guys into the bag. I'm just super excited to review this motherfucking strain. As it is, I already know, my top three favorite of all motherfucking time. So, let's put you guys on game and see what's good. Let's bring you guys into this bag here again. This is that Raspberry Shortcake from Tales and Travels. Boom, got all that artwork on there. Yeah, I know people appreciate that. I mean, I do too. It's just pretty to look at, you know? And then all the info on there, even gives you a QR thing to scan to see all the actual info type shit, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, pairs well with light hikes. We out here, you know what I'm saying? The dessert menu, get a little munchies, and thrifting. Might spring up your mood, you might see something that you never know you even liked, you know what I'm saying? And then on top of that, the moods are weightless, worry-free, and stoked. I'm super stoked, and I haven't even smoked this shit yet. But yeah, we out here in the wilderness, I brought my motherfucking bong with me, my good old faithful, you know what I'm saying? This bitch is dirty, but it gets the job done, people. This bitch got forever stains that I can never get off, so had this bitch since high school. But anyways, people, let's get right into this motherfucker. Grind this shit up, bring you into the bag, pack this bong out here, take some snappers, roll it up, tell you how it tastes, tell you how it smells, explain how it looks, all that shit, you know what I'm saying? If you guys are new here, what it is, what it do, my name is Nico. I do a bunch of strain reviews out here in the beautiful city of Chicago, or fucking Des Plaines River, as you can see. But yeah, I'm out and about with the kush, you know what I'm saying? Always blowing some good smoke in the air, reviewing it for the people, letting them know putting them on, you know what I'm saying? Letting them know what it is and what it do, people. Come on now. If you guys don't know, now you know, baby. Let's get into it. Oh my gosh, dude. As soon as you open the jar and you put your freaking sniffer in here, your nose, it just literally smells like lemon candy with like a little bit of a sour, like a sweet lemon candy, like a lemon heads, with that sour no at the end. It almost lingers to like a different fruit, so I can see where they say raspberry, you know, because it's not like straight lemons. It has like a sweeter, gassy cut at the end with like a sour fruitness. It just all blends in together and gives you that, like, oh my gosh, this is so hard to explain because it's like all over the place, but really it's not. Like, the freaking terp profile on this is some of the best I have ever smelled just coming out of the jar. And again, I had some stinky weed, some really good OGs. This is like right in between. It has that sweet lemon smell, like sugary lemon with like a sour, fruity, gassy sweetness at the end. This shit is so good. You really don't get a cake. It's more of that sour, sweet, fruity note. Ooh, with a little bit of sweetness, that cane sugar, that natural. Oh my gosh, that smells so good. Let's bring you into the bag, baby. Let's see how this motherfucker looks. Now, one thing about these Mylars, you would think that you're gonna get baby ass nugs, but really, look at this chunky monkey right here. Look at this motherfucker. That is a big chunky ass nug, guys, that they gave me. And that is the whole 3.5, you know, I didn't bring the scale out here, but your boy, look, check this out. That is a big old chunky nug, you know what I'm saying? Usually you don't see that shit in little budget buy, as far as like budget buy flowers. You usually see the smalls or shit like that, but these are full premium nugs. That's how you know they're giving you the best that they can, and they ain't hiding nothing from y'all. But yeah, look at this, guys. This shit is so beautiful. I'm trying to give you the best looks right here with the wind blowing in the background. But look at that, guys. The structure on this is just fucking beautiful. Let's go ahead and put you guys at a different angle here. Oh my goodness, let's go ahead and give a little bit of a zoom action here. Yes, there we go, there we go. That is the money shot right there, people. So fire, super frosty. This bitch has been chilling for about 2 months. You can see all those trichomes just on my fingers. Definitely has a little bit of a dense feel, but nothing that's like crazy to where like you can't hand grind this with your fingers if you're rolling a blunt, you know? Breaks apart so easily. Again, super keefy. This shit is just covered in trichomes. The freaking smell is amazing. The bag appeal is freaking on point. It's like, what more can you ask from this, you know? That shit is fucking gas, people. Oh my gosh, I'm telling you, when I fell in love, I really fell in love. Hard eye emojis type shit, you know? Ooh, don't blow my weed away, please. Alright, guys, so yeah, that's how it looks. You know what I'm saying? The breakdown, super trichomey. Has that like forest green structure underneath, but then so much trichomes and keef covered up top that almost looks sandblasted type shit, you know what I'm saying? They like sprinkled this bitch, salt bay, hit it with the pop type shit, you know? But look at this beautiful ass nug. This shit is amazing, guys. Great structure. The breakdown is really nice. It's covered in trichomes. The bag appeal is on point, people. Trim job on point, people. Look at that. They did a really good job in the facility just bagging this bitch up, doing their thing, people. They did a great job just growing this motherfucker, man. Let's go ahead and grind this bitch up, put it in the bong, and then roll her up, man. Again, the smell on this is unbelievable. That sweet lemon cane smell with a little bit of a sour fruitness at the end. It's a little like creamy lingering taste. Shit is so, so good, bro. I can't contemplate it enough, man. Let's roll this shit up and smoke it, people. It's almost a fucking disgrace to do it, but we got it, you know? Good kush don't last long because that motherfucker gets smoked. Alrighty, people. Bong time, baby. It is a little windier than I anticipated, so I'm kind of hoping my weed don't fucking fly away. So let's do this shit quickly, people. But yeah, upon the breakdown, it just grinds up so fluffy. It's so perfect as far as like rolling up goes, because you don't want to roll up nothing that's dusty or like, you know, something that's super stale and just crunch to the touch that turns to dust. You know what I'm saying? You don't want that shit, because that shit don't roll up right. You might as well have gotten shake. Fuck that. But the nug structure is on point. Even for this bitch being packaged 4 months ago, it's still on point in those Mylars. I'm saying on the breakdown, oh my gosh, my smell, poof. Smell your finger after that. Oh my deliciousness. If you guys get that reference, shout out to you guys.
You can feel it first.
Wow.
What do you think?
It feels good.
Smell your finger after that. Oh my deliciousness.
But anyways, man, let's get right into these bong rips here, people. Roll up this motherfucking raspberry shortcake and see what it do out here. I'm saying, and the motherfucking displays river with it, musty as fuck. So I had to bring the good pack with me, people. Let's go. Make sure the motherfucking wind don't eat my shit either. So here we go, peeps. Cheers. I'm gonna get like a small hit, cause that shit blew my shit up. Honestly, I couldn't have picked a worse spot. Helicopters, wind, musty ass river. At least I'm by myself, nobody can hear me. I'm smoking that dope. Holy shit. Bro, even in a bong rip, like a very concentrated smoke, you get that amazing raspberry shortcake fucking taste, bro. Again, it's that super sweet lemon with a little bit of like a sour fruit creaminess. Like, that's like the perfect way to describe it. It has that super sweet lemon sugary taste with like a sour fruit creamy afternote. Perfect, right there. Write it down, take a picture, all that shit. Like Smokey says, I don't give a fuck. Finish the rest of this bong here, man. I'm waiting for the fucking wind to die down. Maybe I should just turn around this way, right? Look how clean that burns in that center. That shit is white, my boy. White. Damn, G, it's like the 20th fucking plane. Y'all ain't get the memo. I'm trying to record here, folk. All right, man, let's go ahead and roll this shit up. Took those snappers. One thing that I'm already gonna note, you know what I'm saying? I just wish it hit a little bit harder in the chest, dog. Maybe that's just how smooth and good it's supposed to be. I'm asking for something that it's never gonna be, you know what I'm saying? It's so smooth, so tasty. And you, like, again, when you're taking fat bong rips, that usually doesn't happen because it's a little bit thick in the smoke. Terpenes are lost. And because it's so thick, that shit, you know what I'm saying, comes in a little rough. Pause. But yeah, that shit is so smooth and so tasty. I feel like I could take a half gram bong rip, no problem. Maybe even a whole G, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, like, the only thing, I wish I could hit a little bit harder, but again, that's probably something that it's just never gonna be because that's just the kind of strain it is. I can appreciate that 100%, so I ain't taking no points off of that, you know what I'm saying? Just because it ain't hit the chest like it, I felt like it was supposed to. It's just so fucking smooth. It's like the perfect strain for somebody who was like, man, I haven't smoked in a while, bro. Or I can't hit a bong because I coughed my ass off, man. Smoke that raspberry shortcake, you'll be good, my boy. Mood elevated, stress relief. Stoked, that's what it said, you know? All that, you gonna feel all that. Mood elevated, worry free, weightless. Start going up type shit, you know? Damn, dog, I need a fucking haircut. But yeah, let's roll this shit up, man. The high, I can already feel, it's definitely that mood elevating high. Nothing that's like a crazy sativa, weird like, you know, type shit. That Durban poison, that Jack Herrera, that shit gets you wired, amped. Red Bull type shit. But this one's like that. This one's kind of like that Miami punch. Very relaxing, mood elevating, ready to go, you know, type shit. Let's roll this up, man, before my weed flies away. Alrighty, people, we back. I ain't even gonna lie, I struggled a little bit, you know what I'm saying? I felt like I was rolling up outside of the park, fucking on lunch break, high school type shit. Like, I was struggling. But anyways, back. One thing I really like about Clipper lighters is that, if you guys didn't know, this little bitch right here actually pops out and becomes a little poker, you know what I'm saying? Fuck using your dirty ass shoelace. I don't know where I put my wooden poker. Shit, somewhere in the crib, but yeah. And it doubles up as a nice little poker, you know what I'm saying, to make sure the J that you rolled is ready to go, my boy. You know, what I'm saying? Give it a nice little 1-2, 1-2 action out here. But yeah, like I said, it's a little windier than I would have thought, so we still smoking this bitch outside though, regardless, you know what I'm saying, people? But yeah, we got that raspberry shortcake, got me feeling right, mood elevated for sure, you know what I'm saying? Definitely feel kind of worry-free. Nah, not as much, as only because I was stressing myself out rolling this bitch outside. But it is what it is, you know what I'm saying? I proled this motherfucker, as I usually do. So, go ahead and just give it the old twist and turn. Pinch, actually, pinch and turn, not full-on twist. Because if you do twist, you're going to end up cutting that airflow out, and it's going to be super tight. I'm not trying to be pulling like, you know, I want my shit smoking. Real good, people. Let's do this. Yeah, got this nice little baby J right here. Again, some of my weed fucking flew away. I was like, fuck it. We rolling what's on the tray. I don't really want to put a little bit more. Oh my gosh, dude. You guys need to be taking dry pulls before you smoke your shit. Again, I apologize for these motherfuckers up here. Chose a fucking goofy ass spot. But anyways, you guys need to start dry pulling your joints before you smoke them. You need this, that smell when you first crack open that jar on the breakdown, that smell, the taste in the joint before you light it up, and then the taste while you light it up. You gotta compare all of those smells and tastes to see if anything is different, if it's all the same throughout, and so far it's all the same throughout. You know what I'm saying, people? It tastes amazing. Again, it's that lemon candy sugar with like a sour, fruity, creamy finish. Oh! So good, man. Let's go ahead and roll this up. Let's actually piece back my lighter here. There you go. It only fits one way, so. Yes, sir. Let's go. Turn this bitch around. Light it up like this. On the back of wind. There you go. Yes, sir. Got to create a little house in my hand, you know. Actually push it away a little farther, like this. A little like this, and I just like cover it, you know what I'm saying? Boom, boom, like that. Tricks, people, the tricks. I'm here to show you all the tricks, man. I'm here to show you all that shit. That's what I'm here for, people. I've been giving the game at a young age. I'm over here just trying to share my expertise with y'all motherfuckers, you know? I'm an educator, people. Don't you forget. Ask me your questions. Make sure this shit's lit right at first. Goddamn. There we go. Ooh. Wow, bro. I can smoke this shit all fucking day. I literally will never get tired of this. I mean, that's why I literally bought like over an ounce until that motherfucker was gone. And now I'm stuck with this shit, hoping till the re-up comes back. I hope Revolution knows how good this fucking raspberry shortcake is. It's fucking phenomenal. Moved up to my top three, you know what I'm saying? Florida Orange, motherfucking Miami Punch are like up there with this bitch, like top three. Sun Queen OG. Royal Wedding. I love my lemon terps and I love my OG terps. Cakes are like third for me, but my OGs and my lemon gas, baby. Super smooth, man. These are the joints, like I'm saying, you could probably roll a whole eighth of, bro. Smoke it to the face. That should be so smooth. Get you high as fuck, but it'd be so smooth. You're not gonna be coughing up a lung smoking this raspberry shortcake. That's what's really, really nice for someone who doesn't want something that's gonna make them cough so much. This is the one. Yeah, the taste is phenomenal. Again, you get those lemon terps, but it lingers to something else. It lingers to something different, that sour sweetness. Yeah, again, taste is phenomenal. The way it looks is phenomenal. The bud structure is phenomenal. How it breaks down is really great. Again, the only thing I would ask of it is if it hit a little bit harder, you know what I'm saying? A little stronger. that's it. But again, this is probably something that's never going to be that. So I can't ask of something that's never going to be, you know what I'm saying? So I got to respect it for what it is. Yeah. You know? So I can, like I said earlier, I can't deduct no points because of that. This shit is a motherfucking 10 out of 10, bro. No cap. Like, this shit is going to be hard to beat. There's a bunch of new strains out there. There's a lot of cookie collabs, you know what I'm saying? Even some other Tales and Travel stuff they got. They got the Quantum Runts, you know what I'm saying? People love the Runts. We're going to have to check that shit out. But yeah, we got the Gone Swishing. We got the Pac-Man that just came out. 2090 shit, powdered sugar. And those are going to be in Mylar bags. I actually just picked up the Mexican Flan in the Cookies Blue bag, you know what I'm saying? So we're going to do a review on that next. Little sneak peek type shit. If you guys don't follow me on Instagram, follow me on there at _findingNico. You'll see all the motherfucking background info, all the behind the scenes shit on there that I post on there right away before I post it on YouTube, you know what I'm saying? So make sure you give your boy a follow and peep me out, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, guys, it's just gonna be really hard to beat again, but there's a lot of new shit out there, man. Fucking plane, bro. What is that, like the 10th one? Shit loud as fuck. Anyways, but yeah, there's a lot of new shit, so you know what I'm saying? I'm super excited if anything takes its place, but so far this is winning. This is up there, bro. 10 out of motherfucking 10. Revolution, Tales and Travels, you guys did your thing with this. Ooh, I tried the Big Willy style dabs, which is a slaps, which is one of the strains that makes this. They use it in that, you know what I'm saying? And it tastes so freaking good. I don't do concentrate reviews often on my channel, only because I'm not like so knowledgeable in that. You know, I can't like really break it down like a fucking nerd like I can do with flower, you know? Need to up my game a little bit. But on the ones that I do really, really like the Lemon Royale I did a review on. I did the one, I think, on the Rollins, Life Sugar. What else did I do? I've taken some dabs. You've seen my channel, you know what I'm saying? I've taken half-gram dabs of shit. If you guys haven't seen the half-gram dab of live rosin I did for 420, check that motherfucking video out, people. Y'all snooze for real, bro. Y'all be snoozing. Watch it all the way to the end, too, bro. But again, I'm super excited for what Revolution is bringing to the motherfucking table. They made that. Oh, shit. They made that connect happen, you know what I'm saying? So shout out to Cookie Man. Shout out Burner. Doing his thing out here with Revolution. The best growers in the motherfucking state. Doing they thing, people. But yeah, new shit to come, man. Super excited for those new cookie strains that are dropping. All that in Mylar bags, too. And they got a bunch of Revolution collabs with the cookies as well. So, just a bunch of new shit, man. So, I'm super excited to review all that and just give you guys, you know, show you what it is, what it do out here, people. But, yeah, overall score on this, I'm going to give it that 10 out of 10, bro. Super clean on the burn and how it smokes. Super smooth, super flavorful. The breakdown is amazing. It's very, very terpy. Terp chasers, terp tasters are going to love this shit for real, bro. Again, super amazed that there's something like this in the market because shit blew my mind. Nowadays, it takes like maybe a year or two to find something new. And it's like, okay, but it's almost like every month or every other month I'm finding something that's like, holy fuck, this shit's fire. So again, big shout out to Revolution for doing y'all thing. Y'all are fucking doing that super bloom for real. New genetics coming out every month. That shit is dope. I love it. But yeah. Give this motherfucker a 10 out of 10, bro. They did their fucking job. They did their thing with this one. They did a great job. Shout out to all the growers. You guys did an amazing job with this one, hunting this one down and making it phenomenal. 10 out of 10. Again, it's gonna be super hard to beat, but there's a lot of new shit out there, so there might be something new that might even go up there, you know what I'm saying? Might be right on the same scale, people. But yeah, go ahead and make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, all that YouTube shit with the post notification bell on so you don't miss any of my new videos. You know, check out some of my old ones. You know, they're bangers. You know what I'm saying? I do reviewing a bunch of shit. I do, like, fishing. I'll do biking. I do a bunch of different shit on my channel, too, you know? All with a doink in the air, people. Should we do a quick push-up challenge? Make me cough real quick? All right, let's go. Another plane. That's, like, the 10th one for sure. Here we go. Quick push-up challenge before we peace out. All right. Calm with me, okay? I'm gonna do five. One big ass one for the road, and that's it. Peace, man. See you on the next one.
It may not mean nothing to y'all, but understand nothing was done for me. So I don't plan on stopping at all. I want this shit forever, man. Never mind, never mind.